It's like, did you see the Patrice O'Neal? Did you see the doc?
I saw like half of it. I saw the first half.
Uh huh.
I ain't finished.
What'd you think of it? What'd you think of it so far? Did you see it, Dre?
Yeah.
It was cool.
What'd you think?
Dope.
It was dope. Fucking it was dope. Yeah, it was dope.
I'm a huge
dope.
Fan of Patrice, man.
Yeah. But then like yeah, once I seen what other like people that like was closer to him was saying, because then I look at it like that too. I think for me, where I'm like, yo, if niggas that was around him was like, I gotta be like, yo, these niggas was around. Like, there's people that like been saying, like, yo, these comedy. Although it's dope to see like the praise, but like I seen a few people that was like, yo, or heard a few people like, nah, Comedy Central and the Cellar didn't even fuck with him like that. Like, why would they even do that? So that shit kind of made me look at it like, damn, I hope if anything else, niggas is getting broken off, like at least with some coins. You know what I'm saying? That it's like,
well, here's the thing I would say,
because I know other people making money off of it is what I'm saying too. Like,
yeah, if but they
it out, yeah,
they definitely look. I think it was a good depiction of him as the man, right? In the fact that they showed that he had layers to him and stuff like that, and him and you didn't
he was
see the
a
whole
tremendous
thing,
performer,
but
he also had some flaws both.
And there was all
kind
of, no, but I don't mean that. I'm saying they showed that he had layers in terms of he was layered in terms of he wasn't just a dude who was funny or aggressive or stuff. And you see him with his stepdaughter, and you see him with Vaughn, and they talk about when Vaughn was pregnant. I remember when Vaughn got pregnant, and he talked to me, and then he basically tells Vaughn, I don't think I'm gonna live a long time, and I don't want to leave you with a baby. He goes like, I can't tell you what to do, but I don't want to leave you with a baby. And so that's why they didn't have the baby. So a lot of times they be talking about Vaughn, you know, and on the internet be talking about Vaughn crazy, but Vaughn was his girl, like right, for right. 10 joints. Like she cooked for him. She gave him his medication.
Hold on, before you got on here, I was just telling them, Harry and Dre, about like how shorties a lot of times, like even say like what you, because it sparked it with what you saying about Vaughn. Mm-hmm. It's like that, yo, short, like the at least not even all shorties, but like the, you know, the ones that you the closest with.
Yeah,
shorties be doing free therapy for real niggas. Like, we come home, like if they wanted to ruin us, they would tell all our friends, yo, they don't even like y'all niggas like that. Like, cause you only gonna tell a shorty that's like you wit that. That's like everything. You feel me?
Well, let me put it like this. I'm not gonna blow niggas up, but there's a lot of niggas on there that was like, he was my best. He was like, that nigga's funny style. Nah, that nigga's a bootlicker. Yeah, that nigga's Shade Street. It was like he was on, like, but it's what's real funny is the thing of them saying, you know, like the, I thought it showed a good dimension, right? You agree with that, Harry? I mean, we talked about the stuff that wasn't true.
It's a he was a complicated guy. He was a tremendously funny guy, but a very complicated guy, both professionally and personally, and even his friends. So it's weird because when you say all that stuff that he said about his friends and or his, you know, like, oh, this guy sucks, that didn't mean that they weren't his friends in a weird way, because he talked shit to and behind a lot of people and professionally. And I didn't know him super well. I was only around him. But even professionally, like, there were things that he did to sabotage himself. He's still tremendously an amazing performer and one of the greatest of all time. There's no doubt about that.
And I've always said that he did a lot of things to sabotage himself. And it's funny, Harry, because I was thinking a lot of that is not necessarily true. It is. I'm not saying that he didn't play ball, but here's what happened. As a black performer, they expect you not just to play ball, but you got to play ball. They want you to put the dress on. You got to take this shit that you would never do to any white performer, they do to a black performer. And Patrice was just a dude who would go, I'm not doing that. Now, I'm not saying he didn't take, there were certain opportunities he could have taken advantage of, and you never know what's going to blow you up or not. But you can't, it's weird to say, you know, it was almost like when they were trying to give him opportunities, it was, hey, black dude, we are giving you a shot. You should be grateful. Now smile and tap dance. And he wasn't, the reality was, as dope as then, and I'll check this out, Harry, as dope as all his peers talk about how dope he was, he should have gotten everything that they gave him and more, whether he turned it down or not. But because he was a black dude who said, oh, this project's not right for me, this is not right for me, then it was held against him as being difficult. Because why? Because he was a black dude who didn't
kowtow down. He wasn't the status quo. So
he was saying, he was like, I don't want to do this. I'm not comfortable with this.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think, because while I'm like, do you think like if he wasn't like, if say like the time we live in now, minus the pandemic and all that shit, but
right.
in a sense of like how podcasts have picked up in the last 10, 15 years.
Yeah.
Maybe he would have had a different like outlet, because it's not like he didn't have like he would have built it.
He was getting ready to break. He was breaking in the old outlet.
Young man school 202. Better hear what I've got to say, because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man. Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.